Capricorns, welcome to your heart spread readings for the end of October time frame. Heart spreads, 8-card reading that ends up in the shape roughly of a heart, and it reads who's on your mind, who's in your heart. I'm an astrologer too, so if I throw out the signs, it's just as you would for resonating with readings. Consider sun, moon, rising, and Venus, you know, in these love readings, which is what this is really. And always on Fridays, it's Sagittarius Capricorn Day. And I do, if you have any friends that are totally completely single, I also have a singles read. It's very different. Also 8 cards. Meet your soulmate read. So, but this one is for the one that you're really thinking of, the one that's most on your mind, the one that's really, I know it's ooky romantic. Yeah, they're in your heart, right? This is like who's in your heart. End of October time frame, Capricorns, heart spread. It's my hallmark spread I came up with years ago, working for years, really. It's my Sagittarius workhorse, strong Sagittarius, married to a Capricorn for 25 years, respect. Okay, here we go. The world, wow, Capricorn. So I see this as your energy in and around relationships where your mind and heart is at now. And I detach that some. I try to here is the intention from your other person. So this is kind of a baseline about where you're kind of at as a person. And you would be someone that really has leveled up. This is leveling up energy. You know, I always say completing a cycle, but typically what that means, like you graduated from high school, graduated from college, became a partner at the law firm, got a large promotion, got your graduate or doctorate degree, really leveling up somewhere, somehow. And you're kind of, with this one too, you're kind of looking back away from the reading. I always take note of that here. So it tells me it's interesting who you're thinking of, because you're kind of into yourself, not in a bad way, but you know, when this happens, probably there's a lot probably going on. No, excuse me, I gotta have some coffee. There's a lot going on that you're taking care of. Sort of like your life has your attention, or you are really engaged in your life. Very actively engaged in your life. You know, next comes the Fool. It'd be cool to get the Fool in your number 3 position. Let's see. Now here's your person. I swear, and I shuffled 5 of Swords. That's their energy. What a difference. Man, the negative readings today. I'm sorry. This is how it's rolling. It's been really positive. This is not positive. I'm trying to think if there's another way to go with this, but the main way I see this, you're going away from this person in this reading. I'd put it this way. And this is the person you're moving away from. They're not on board with your growth. You outgrew them. I don't know how to say this. You know, it happens. We know this happens. It's kind of nobody's fault. I mean, you could say, oh, well, they should have grown. Well, you know, you can't really say that. You know, you could, but what good is that? It's just kind of low vibe, and it's like, so you're really doing the right thing. You're focusing on what you've achieved and where you're going, and you know, they're not happy about it, and they're probably trying to pull you down, arguing with you. I normally see this energy as something outside, but this person's energy is strongly attached to you. That's the problem. It's like they're coming after you here. They're coming after you, and you're trying to get away. I think you will get away. You've got the energy of the world here. Just, you know, you're about to jump off the cliff, and then where's that going to leave them? Like in one of those movies, wah, wah, you get away. Do you live or not? Fool will. Maybe they don't know it. They looked in, oh, they're dead. No, not fool, somehow. Parachutes to safety. Star card. Overall energy. I do count that nowadays for the heart spread. There may have been some kind of manifestation here. Maybe that's how you got the world. You know, some similarities in the colors, too. So, but I think that world is on you. Kind of a story here. Kind of stop it now, but let's see where this is going to go. But I kind of know 10 of Cups, how you feel about them. It's very hard for you because they're your 10 of Cups person. Yeah, the manifestor card, you may have feel like you manifested them. Maybe you're a manifester. You manifested them and you manifested your way away from them. And King of Wands. So I just really don't like this. The King of Wands, I'm not saying King of Wands is bad, but this is their baseline. And then now in the position of how they're reacting to you, in the position of how you're reacting to them is the Ten of Cups. That's with an understanding, an emotional connection, a real, true, deep love. In my opinion, it doesn't necessarily have to mean you want to be with them. It appears to me like you don't. But you do understand that they're the mother, father of your children. Here, Capricorns, you do understand that you can't just walk away from your love and feelings from them. But I think you have to walk away from this terrible negativity that you've probably been tolerating a while. And now, reacting to you, the King of Wands. This is not really good. And he's looking right. You kind of look at the way the King of Wands is looking right at you over here at your Ten of Cups. It's kind of almost cynical, controlling. It's wands, so it could be actions. They could be taking actions to take advantage of you. You've got the world because of the person you are. You earn this. You don't get the world by sitting on your laurels and fucking up. You know, you get the world by living a good life and doing what you need to do and all that. You know, and here, even the way you're thinking of them, it's in this very loving Ten of Cups way. And they're with the Five of Swords, bitter and arguing and just looking at you finally. It's almost, I feel really it's just anger. It's like you would think this love that you're sending them, which is unconditional love, you know, once you detach and you're still like, you know, really caring about someone, even if it's like, hey, you know, I don't want to be married to you, I don't want to have sex with you, I want to be away from you, but I love you and I care about you and I want you to be okay. And, you know, if they can't appreciate that, I mean, that says a lot right there. And I think not only do they not appreciate it, but really it just sort of makes them angry and more bitter. And it's just a really self-righteous energy to this King of Wands reaction. And look here, this is your advice from spirit. What's that say? Get away, get the fuck away, right? Get away, right? So Six of Swords, this is your advice from spirit towards this person, towards this relationship. And that is definitely the advice of get away. Mentally get away. And it's coming under the Ten of Swords. It's trying to say, I believe here, it's pretty clear here. This is not an obtuse reading, pretty direct. This nostalgia could be with the Ten of Cups, this wanting to love, it's great, but protect yourself and move away from this energy here that's negative. At least get it out of your mind. Have an intention to move away from this, you know. Like if this person here needs to call you and complain, they're going to be negative and try to bring you down. I hate to go with the narcissist stuff, but it could be some narcissist type stuff. That's when you do the Six of Swords and you walk away from that stuff. And even here, the Page of Wands is looking right at your Six of Swords. Now I hate to say this, but there could be a child involved. Because the Six of Swords is looking at the Page of Swords. And this is advice from spirit. And, you know, I think this is advice from spirit that you're going to take this child with you. Probably a fire sign child, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Yeah. And it's coming under the King of Wands. There's some, to me, it could be that your person here, I could see that one of the actions they may take, these are both wands, they may try to control you. And assert control over you, dominance over you. They might actually want to hurt you. They might just flat out, it's unimaginable to me why people don't understand about anything, but they have this kind of energy. But they might actually want to hurt you by controlling this child in this relationship and kind of against you. You know, it's God knows it's not unheard of. Excuse me. Well. Advice from spirit is death. My God. Yes, transformation. I think what this is really talking about, it's going to be a transformative process for both of you. Went through this with the last reading. similar theme, because probably all relationships are soulmate relationships. All relationships have a lesson. Check out the Mercury retrograde readings I did over last weekend. They're for every sign, not that long, and that checks in with the person that was like the one that got away energy, the one you kind of have on your mind for one reason or another, but you know it's never going to happen. But looking at how that's important, because relationships are how we grow and learn. And this is talking about this entire relationship for both people is about transformation and growth. And my opinion is you got it. You're the world. You're on it. You're transformed. You're now ready to fly off and be the butterfly, you know. And your person here, I could definitely see them stewing in this and having a hard time working through this transformation. Like, you know, transformation, like this person, they probably projected this shit out of all their negativity all over you, Capricorn, for years and years. And now they can't. So let's say go get another person, God help them, which, you know, King of Wands, they might. They got to deal with it themselves. Boom. Transform, bitch. You know? Deal with your stuff. For you, I think it's you're dealing with your stuff. You've got extra. You can still love bad people and undeserving people. Yes. Seven of Swords. I'm not really surprised by this outcome. And remember, it's coming over the Death card. They're both Scorpio cards, in my opinion. But this is the energy of strategic thinking now. And it's coming between your Ten of Cups and your King of Wands. Your Ten of Cups is you reacting to your person. Their reaction is the King of Wands towards you. And this Seven of Swords is looking back down at the transformation. So it's almost, I get the feeling like out of this transformation, they're still going to want to take advantage of you. A lot of this is mental energy. I think this is an important reading. I mean, if you ever considered a personal reading, if you could look at your own astrology, the synastry, this should be there. Make sure you really understand what's going on here. Because I see this person at every point, they're going to try to take an advantage of you. And I'll be clear, they're going to try to cheat you in every which way. And it could be very subtle. They're going to try to use the plutonic forces of control over you at every point. Why? It's coming over death. They're not accepting this transformation. They're not doing the work. You know, they're bucking up against this. You know, you took the other route, okay? You went along with the transformation. But I believe what is being said here is just you need to think strategically as well and defensively in this area. You know, the Six of Swords and the Seven of Swords, those are yours. This outcome is yours. It's not a relationship here. So the outcome is advice for you. And I think it's, the advice here is to kind of be protective of yourself with this other person. Very underlying energy is negative from this person. And I, as an energy worker, I don't see how this would help you to deal with this kind of energy. So it's a perfect time to cut it off and to move into your whole new life with this world energy. That's yours. And you're taking it away from this negative relationship. So thank you guys. It was a cheery reading, but like, thumbs up maybe, share particularly if you think it's relevant with a friend or something. And I do appreciate everyone subscribing if you would. Helps me a lot. Comments help. Love to hear it.